You're logged on to IndianTimesDaily.com, the only portal for news from India, America, Canada, Punjab and Gujarat. In English, Punjabi and Gujarati, with a list of well-established businesses and resources that you may need. I'm Prerna Sharma and today's headlines are... In India, Pakistan has protested against the denial of visas to pilgrims seeking to visit Ajmer Sharif, and the Sensex has plunged to a three-month low. In America, the Trump administration will work with India on the Rohingya crisis, and the Indian government may move the WTO against the US. In Punjab, ministers will pay their own income tax, and hookah bars are set to be permanently banned. Stay tuned to IndianTimesDaily.com, and I'll be back with all the news that's important for you from India, America, and Punjab. Welcome back to Indian Times Daily. The top 10 headlines from India are... The denial of visas to over 500 Pakistani pilgrims seeking to visit Ajmer Sharif has been slammed by Islamabad. Earlier, India and Pakistan had traded charges over their diplomats being harassed in each other's capitals. New Delhi stated that the prevailing circumstances and absence of security clearances were the reason for its decision. Key Indian equity indices on Monday hit their lowest level since December 6, 2017. The BSE Sensex slipped below the 33,000 mark and the Nifty 50 of the NSE fell below the psychologically important 10,100 level. Jailed former Bihar Chief Minister Lalu Prasad has been convicted in the fourth fraud scam case pertaining to illegal withdrawal of money from government treasury in the 1990s. The judge will hear arguments on the quantum of sentence from March 21st. Another ex-Chief Minister Jagannath Mishra was acquitted in the case. Telangana Chief Minister K. Chandrasekhar Rao and West Bengal Chief Minister Mamata Banerjee have pitched for a non-Congress, non-BJP federal front. Amidst political churning ahead of Lok Sabha elections, they stated the need for a national alternative. Delhi Chief Minister Arvind Kejriwal has apologised to BJP leader and Union Minister Nitin Gadkari and Congress leader Kapil Sibal. This is for making unverified allegations of corruption against them. A move his rivals reciprocated by withdrawing defamation cases. Senior separatist leader Syed Ali Gilani has stepped down from the chairmanship of his party Tehreek-e-Hurriyat. He held the position for 18 years. Senior Hurriyat leader Mohammad Ashraf Seherai has replaced Gilani as the party chairman. India has summoned Pakistan's Deputy High Commissioner Syed Haider Shah and launched a strong protest over the loss of lives of five Indian civilians. They were killed in unprovoked ceasefire violations by Pakistan from across the LOC in Jammu and Kashmir on Sunday. The Karnataka cabinet has decided to grant the Lingayats the status of a separate religion. The move comes in a bid to woo the dominant community in the state ahead of the assembly elections. An Indian Army video has accused Chinese hackers of targeting soldiers using the messenger service WhatsApp. Over the past few years, some Indian Armed Forces personnel have been trapped to spy against their homeland. Bollywood actress Deepika Padukone has the most followed account and cricket star Virat Kohli has got the most engaged account on Instagram. These are as per the Instagram awards, which have been announced for the first time in India. Stay tuned to Indian Times Daily as the news from America and Punjab follows. Welcome back to Indian Times Daily. The top 10 headlines from America are... The Trump administration will work with India on Rohingya crisis by helping to fulfill refugee needs in Bangladesh. The US will also pressurize Myanmar to take back refugees. Nearly 7 lakh Rohingya Muslims fled Myanmar following a crackdown by the military. The Indian government may move the WTO against the US. This is following the dispute between the two countries over a rise in import duty of aluminium and steel. Trump had last month announced a sudden imposition of hefty taxes on steel imports. Indian Navy Chief Sunil Lamba will visit the US to strengthen defense ties. The five-day trip will focus on bilateral naval cooperation. China's presence in South China Sea and its assertive behavior in the Indian Ocean region has been a concern for both countries. The United States' South Asia policy is on the right path despite challenges posed by Pakistan's lack of progress. The policy announced by Trump last August has bolstered the confidence of the US-Afghan partners. China has urged the US to correct its mistake on the approval of a US-Taiwan Travel Act. According to it, US officials and its Taiwanese counterparts can travel to each other's country more easily. However, China sees Taiwan as a renegade province and has long stated its desire for reunification. President Donald Trump has attacked the fairness of Robert Mueller's investigation into Russian election meddling. Trump has insisted that the probe is underway with hardened Democratic staff. German Economy Minister Peter Altmaier has warned the US that it cannot break the European Union over trade. Peter's statement comes ahead of his visit to Washington. He claimed that the European Union is a customs union and act collectively, and any attempt by the US to divide it will fail. A New York City firefighter, Thomas Fallon, who saved hundreds of people during the 9/11 attack, has died of cancer. Fallon was 45. Over 170 firefighters have died till date due to illnesses related to the 9/11 attack. Saudi Arabia's powerful Crown Prince Mohammed bin Salman will be visiting the US for a week-long visit. He's set to strengthen ties and seek investment opportunities between the two countries. US President Donald Trump's approval rating has improved slightly, according to a new poll. 43% of Americans have approved of the president's performance in office, a 4-point increase from another poll in January. I'll be back. Stay logged on to IndianTimesDaily.com as the news from Punjab follows. Welcome back to Indian Times Daily. The top 10 headlines from Punjab are: Ministers in the State Assembly, including Chief Minister Amrinder Singh, will pay their own income tax from this month. The Cabinet has cleared the decks for the proposed amendment. The state shells out 11.08 crore rupees for income tax clearance of ministers. The state has decided to impose a permanent ban on hookah bars, instead of issuing temporary orders against them every 2 months. This will be tabled in the coming budget session. The move is aimed at reducing the trend of hookah and hookah bars, beside the use of tobacco in various forms amongst youngsters. To overcome shortage of medical staff, the state government will recruit MBBS doctors on full salaries, including giving all allowances during probation too. Earlier, only a basic pay was allocated for newly appointed medical officers in the Health and Family Welfare Department. Former SED Minister Sucha Singh Langa has been granted bail in a rape case filed against him. Langa was booked for allegedly raping a Punjab police woman constable. A video proof was submitted by the complainant. The woman, however, later retracted from her statement. Chief Minister Amrinder Singh has questioned the SED move to lay siege at the State Assembly on the initial day of budget session. He challenged SED leader Sukhbir Singh Badal to pressurize the centre into waiving off farmer debts instead of indulging in theatrics. The SED has released a video footage of alleged poll rigging and bogus voting during the municipal corporation elections in Patiala. The CD was sought under the RTI from the Deputy Commissioner in Patiala. The PPCB has advised the use of reverse osmosis for purification of water to be limited. Rosh should be used at places where the level of total dissolved solids in water is above 750 mg per litre. Essential minerals were removed during the RO process, leading to hypertension, cardiovascular handicaps and diabetes. Congress workers offered pakoras to BJP supporters attending the Saffron Party's Bajao Dhol Kholo Pol rally. They were taking a dig at Modi's recent remark that pakora sellers should be counted among employed people. The workers also distributed dummy checks of 15 lakh rupees each, drawn from Feco Bank. Members of the Anganwadi Workers Union have protested at PCCC President Sunil Jakhar's native village, Pantkhosi. The dharna was staged for not fulfilling the government's promise to associate Anganwadi workers with the education of children in pre-primary classes at government-run schools. Popular Punjabi singer Jasbir Jassi is turning down Bollywood songs due to their double-meaning lyrics. The singer is disturbed with the portrayal of Punjabi music in a wrong way in some songs and videos. Jassi said he would explore Sufi songs. This is the end of the news bulletin, but stay tuned to IndianTimesDaily.com as news from Bollywood is coming up next. And do visit the resources section on this portal to find the best Indo-American businesses and resources, from accounting firms to wedding planners in your city. All of us at Indian Times Daily wish that you have a great day.
Finally, the wait is over as the much-awaited first look of Salman Khan from his upcoming film Race 3 is out. Yes, the hero of Race 3 himself shared his dashing look from the film on his Twitter handle. In the poster, the superstar is seen in a formal look wearing a black shirt, pinstriped trousers, a black blazer and a blue tie. He rounded his sexy look by teaming it up with a pair of black sunglasses and a gun in his hand. Salman captioned it, "Is hafte milta hu Race 3 ki family se. Mera naam hai Sikandar. Selfless over selfish. Race 3 this Eid." Going by the tweet, this week is going to be an exciting one for Bhaijaan's fans as he will introduce the whole star cast of the film, including Jacqueline Fernandez, Bobby Deol and Anil Kapoor. The third installment of the franchise is helmed by Remo D'Souza, which also stars Saqib Saleem and Daisy Shah in pivotal roles. It is set for an Eid release this year, that is June 15, 2018. The team is currently in Abu Dhabi for the final schedule. Madhuri Dixit has been cast in a role which was to be played by Sridevi in Abhishek Varman's new directorial, the late actress's daughter Janhvi Kapoor said on Monday. Janhvi posted on Instagram page, "Abhishek Varman's next film was very close to mom's heart. Dad, Khushi and I are thankful to Madhuri ji for now being a part of this beautiful film." She also shared a warm photograph featuring Madhuri and Sridevi, who were considered professional rivals at one point in their careers. Post Ae Dil Hai Mushkil, Karan Johar has been trying to make another magnum opus titled Shiddat, and according to reports, he has apparently brought Varun Dhawan, Alia Bhatt, Aditya Roy Kapoor and Sanjay Dutt on board for the film. It is being said that Varun and Aditya will be seen playing brothers with a tense relationship. Meanwhile, Sanjay Dutt and Madhuri will be portraying the characters of their parents. The film is set in India-Pakistan partition period.